again, I'm Suzanne Perry, founder of LoveShouldn'tHurt.tv. Today is the 22nd day of October. Have you been following along? Have you been learning some information here? We're here to talk about domestic violence and maybe help share some information maybe you didn't know before. And hopefully you can share these videos with some friends or colleagues or co-workers or what have you. This is my baby Patrick. All right, so today we're going to talk about the three stages of abuse. There is the honeymoon phase, and during the honeymoon phase, this is when it's awesome. You guys get along really well, and all those wonderful feelings are going on. You're getting along, you're communicating, you may get gifts. You go out to dinner, and it's awesome. You go home, and you have a great night, if you know what I mean. And everything is just blooming and blossoming, and you just hope it always stays that way. Little do you know that abusive partner is actually starting to simmer. Stuff is starting to build up. But it doesn't look that way. And so now we have the tension building phase, where the abusive partner starts getting nitpicky, picking on stuff, little things. Sorry, that's Patrick's toy. He's so happy. He's my baby. So this stage is slowly building up while you're wondering what the heck's going on, but it's subtle, so you're not seeing any red flags yet, but they're just starting to be a little bit of a pain. And then that will escalate and escalate, and you can't do anything right, and escalate and escalate, and all of a sudden, bam! Now it's the explosion phase. And this is where the abusive partner lets loose, whatever that means for that person. It could be screaming at you, throwing things. It may be hitting you. It may be, you know, sexually assaulting you. It could be any number of things. So now it's full-fledged. Now, when this happens, the abuser, whoo, it all releases. And this is kind of like a druggie on a fix. They're energized by that. When they're rah, letting loose, it's exerting control over you because now you're scared. You're like, what the heck's going on? And they are dominating you, your behavior, your reactions. They're completely in control because they appear that they're out of control. But the sad part is they know exactly what they're doing and they're never really out of control. So they're addicted to that feel-good hormone that releases. When they blow up, you pretty much cower and bow down and succumb to them. Reinforces that. Reinforces their power. All right, Patrick. He's my baby. So once the tension releases and the big blowout happens, you might have a black eye. You might, who knows? But then the dust settles and it returns to the honeymoon phase. Oh, I'm so sorry. If I ever do that again, I'll go to counseling. Don't leave me. I don't know if I could ever go on. And they will spread it on really thick. But they'll do whatever they need to do to make you believe them. They'll lie. They'll make themselves cry. They'll do whatever it takes so that you believe them. Patrick! Sniffing my camera stand. Don't do that. So these are the three cycles. We have the honeymoon phase, where it's awesome. The tension building phase, nitpicky. And then the explosion, when all hell breaks loose. And then it returns again. That is the cycle of abuse. And it just continues. And with each cycle, over a period of time, it gets worse. And it will turn physical. It may. Hi, sweetie. My son Joey's home. Patrick's excited. I'm Suzanne Perry. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again tomorrow.